Welcome back to Kryptonite Physics. Our subject today is relative motion and inertial reference frames. What is relative motion? We can say it is motion measured relative to another point. That point may be fixed or in motion. You are walking through the fair with a friend, in the same direction, at the same speed, 2 miles per hour. Relative to the ground, both of you are walking at 2 miles per hour. Relative to each other, you are not moving. If you speed up to 3 miles per hour, you will be traveling at 3 miles per hour relative to the ground, but only 1 mile per hour relative to the other person. Relative motion is measuring those differences. Look at this fairground ride. Its track is very long, level, and straight. On the track is a rotating platform with several seats for riders and a large perspex dome to protect us from the weather. You and your friend, sitting together, get on the ride. The ride isn't rotating yet. It is just traveling along the track at a constant velocity of 4 miles per hour. The ride is an inertial reference frame. If the velocity of the ride stays constant, all the riders will have the same experience as being on ride C, that is not moving at all. This is the same as you would be in a train that's traveling at a constant velocity. The ride stops, it just rotates. You are now moving at a tangential velocity of 3 miles per hour. The ride experience will be the same as on ride B. What happens when the two motions are combined, rotation and moving along the track? Your motion is now a combination of the two velocities, 3 miles per hour and 4 miles per hour. You are now accelerating and decelerating at a constantly changing rate. At a minimum velocity of 1 mile per hour up to a maximum of 7 miles per hour. Your ride experience is not the same as being on ride B or C. You and the people on the ride could say that relative to each other, you are not moving. But that would not be the reality of the ride experience. If you walked to the very center of the ride, you could say, relative to you, the riders are on ride B, just rotating. Again, this is not the reality of the ride experience for the people still in their seats. Only relative to a fixed point outside of the ride can you see and calculate the reality of the ride. What has this physics shown us? That the relative to position can change the math, but it cannot change the overall reality for the riders. All motion is relative, but you can change the relative to point to change the math. Only a fixed point away from all motions can show the true reality of what is happening. The math is not always the reality.